In this video, we're going to show you how to log into the NHS app if you've forgotten your password. So tap on the app to open it. Then once it's loaded, along the bottom, that continue with NHS login. So just tap on there. So you need to type in the email address that you think you've used. We just start typing on here. If it's your phone and you have an email account on there, once you start typing, it will usually pop up with the email address. So you've got a few, so just choose the one that you would have signed up with. If you haven't, you'll just need to type the full email address in. Once the email address is in, just tap continue. And here it tells us that we've got an NHS login. If you haven't used the NHS app before and you haven't got a login, it will tell you at this point and then follow the steps to set up an account, which will be on a different video. If you have forgotten your NHS login details, tap continue, and this is where it will be. Enter your password. So you can have a try if you think you might remember it. It's always worth a guess. If you have a password that you use on a few sites, or a password that you know that you've used, you can try them in here. If you know that you can't remember it, if you've got no idea, or you've tried a few times and it doesn't accept any of the passwords you put in, just tap reset it. This will send a link to your email address. So what you'll need to do, if you've got the email on your phone, tap your home button, which is usually the middle button at the bottom. So we'll tap that, which will take us to the main screen. Then you'll just need to locate where your email account is. If it's a Google, just open up the Gmail. In this instance, we've got an Outlook account, so we'll tap on the Outlook. In your inbox, you should see it be the latest email in there. No reply, login at NHS UK. So tap on it to open it up. Then there, there'll be a link to reset your password. So where it's written there in green, reset your password, just tap on the link. Once you've tapped on the link, it will take you to the NHS login page on the website where you'll reset your password. So if you just scroll down, and then you'll need to enter the you'll need to enter the password twice, following the rules that are stated on there. So at least 8 characters, an uppercase, not start or end with a blank space. Once you've typed the first one in, tap under where it says confirm password. And repeat what you've put in. Take your time to put that in, because it is very easy on the little keyboards on your phone to mishit a key. So what you can do, as long as it's safe to do so, is tap on the show. And on the show, and you can check to see whether both are the same. If they are, you can hide them again or just tap reset password. Here we've got a message to update our password. So if you want to save that to your Google account, you can do. You can just tap continue. It'll confirm that your username, which is your email address, which will be linked to the password that you've just set up. And here we've got the message, you have reset your password for the NHS login. Now if you tap your home button, you go back to the NHS app, tap on it to open it again. And then we want to enter login details. So tap enter login details. And then tap in the password field to bring up your keyboard. And then enter the password that you've just set up. You can tap show if you wish to make sure you've typed it in correctly. Once you've typed it in, tap continue. And here we've got the option as well to save the password to Google. So this will save it on the app, whereas the previous one saved it on the website, which is accessing the NHS login through your web browser, so through Safari on an iPhone or through Google Chrome on an Android phone. This will save it for the password for the app, which is the NHS app. So you can either, if you'd rather not, tap not now, or you can save and it'll remember it. Next, we'll have to check your mobile phone. So this is sending a security code to the mobile phone that you're on as an extra security. So usually if you've received the text message, you can see here, it's got the 6-digit code and we can copy it direct from messages. The other option is you can swipe down from the top. Swipe down from the top and there you go. It's got the last message received there, NHS login, so you can memorize that if you wish. Or write it down. And then just type it in there. If you're copying it from your messages, which is above the keyboard, you can just tap that and it'll input the 6 digits there. If this is a mobile phone that you regularly use, it's very useful to tap the box there where it says remember this device. So the next time you log in, it will not ask for a security code once you've put in your username and password. Once you've done this, tap continue. If it's been a while since you've logged in, they may have updated the terms and conditions. You can either choose to read those terms and conditions, any updates to the privacy notice or the cookies policy by tapping on them. If you're happy, tap where it says agree and continue. You'll check your details. Next we get the notifications on or off option. So this is to whether you allow the NHS app to send you notifications on any updates regarding the app or yourself as a patient with the NHS to your phone. If you tap no, it requires you to check the NHS app for any updates. If you tap yes, then your phone will send you notifications to let you know there's been an update, whether that's about the NHS app or you as a patient, could be to do with your prescriptions, pharmacy, or any test results that you may have had. Once you made your decision, tap continue. Then it will give you the option if you want to turn on your fingerprint or face recognition, depending on what you've set up on your phone. So if you've got fingerprint security set up on your phone, or if you've got face ID, you can use these to sign in next time. So it usually asks for your email address, and then instead of putting your password in, it will either check your face ID or check your fingerprint ID. So this can be quite useful if you can't remember your password that you've put in, or if you just want quick access rather than having to type your password out each time. It will just check your fingerprint or face ID to get you straight on. Depending on what you've decided, either tap yes or no. So we're going to tap yes. Once you've signed in, it will take you to the main home page. We'll have the message here, prove your identity to get full access. And so if this is the first time you've used the NHS app, or if it's been a while since you last used it, use your NHS logins, you may or may not have full access to the NHS app. Full access will allow you to book appointments with your GP surgery, if that service is available. And the other main one is to order your any repeat prescriptions through the app. If you don't have full access, the message here will be displayed and you'll need to provide further ID to prove your identity to get that full access. So that's how to reset your password and then log into the NHS app. Thanks for watching.